Advanced density is what I would like to add to your discussion of today. It's not coincidence that this conference and this subject goes together with this news of a couple of weeks ago. And that actually, at the same moment, we are predicting for the coming 30 years still some growth on the planet. And that at the same moment that those will be mainly housed on this kind of places, on our cities. So density is and remains a hot issue for the coming generation. What to do in that case? And I was asked to go back for a moment into a book that we made, I think 10 years ago, which was our first excursion on density. In one of those chapters, we were trying to understand what density would mean in more factors, more social environment, more culture, but also other kind of elements. So this was a shocking, say, partly shocking analysis, where, for instance, if I go to this chapter, you see certain correlations between the growth in densities and the number of road accidents, obviously. But if you go, for instance, to the more like seemingly arbitrary section, you could start to imagine that all those people that say, if I make it denser, then I get more crime or I get more sex offenses. It's dangerous over there. That we try to to unravel that at that moment. So here a relationship in Latin America, nota bene, between density and sex offense. The denser you build at that moment, the lower the sex offenses. Or in Europe, an equivalent at that moment. Most of our sex offenses are in the villages, as clearly it can be stressed in Belgium. So how does it then in Asia? Similar. So in general, I would say, this is the global graph and summary about that. Sex offense and density has more opportunities when it's denser. If I go to another crime, if I put all the crime together, in Europe and the US, the denser, the less crime, including the sex offense. In Asia, it's the opposite, still. And I'm curious about it, how that would happen. And in Africa, but in general, on the planet, it's quite equal. To be honest. So, neutralizing a little bit the discussion on that subject. How to go further on this subject? Can it lead then to other kind of cities? Can we then take that one step further to make our cities better, our dense cities much better? So we try to do that actually in quite a sequence of observations. We cannot do that in one subject. Crime and violence and other aspects that surround this increase in density. There are more aspects to do that. So this is a sequence of our, say, density studies, our advanced density studies. We want to incorporate animals in the future in our cities. I love that foxes will soon be found in Amsterdam. We want to automate until how far our cities in that way to make our densities more believable and more advanced. We want to accelerate in order to give density more cohesion and more quality as such. So how far can we go? Can we reach any destination in 5 minutes in the near future? I would like to illustrate it a little bit with another technique, it's more on the practical side, how we can love density and can encourage that to develop. This is Hong Kong, a study that we made and that just comes out in the coming weeks, where we fantasize and speculate on what Hong Kong, my love affair with Hong Kong as one of the best densest places on the planet, how we can not only learn from it, how Hong Kong can come better as such. World class is a kind of definition that we more and more use in order to define standards and goals for our city. So why not make that more applicable on density? So look on the right, how comparative analysis could lead to a possible agenda for even for Hong Kong in that way. Because if I look to the quality of living in Hong Kong, it's quite low, shockingly. I didn't know. Or if I look, for instance, to this sector, to the education index, it still needs work to do. Or if I look then to other zones, like in this case, the number of museums or culture, there's another definition, seemingly, of culture in Hong Kong. If I then look to other aspects, like public transport here below, that's fantastic. You beat the rest of the planet with that. That's what density is about. And if I go to other aspects, like to nature, then indeed you have the greenest city and on that planet. So how to bring that then one step further? I think architects need not only to show graphs, they have to show images that seduce or that help a little bit to spatialize that kind of suggestions. So let's imagine that you invest in culture. Let's imagine that after the competition of West Kowloon, we would like to connect those two places. I could dig, I could open up some of your tunnels and turn it into new vast, valleys that connect the two sides, where this kind of, say, housing could be imagined and turning into this kind of, say, fantasies. Okay, a little bit jokey, I guess. But let's go further, investing in nature. Your embracement with nature is like rather primitive. And it's kind of defense strategy when you go into your mountains. Let's embrace them better, go into it, and turn it into accessible zones where you can make your innovative housing. And yes, another poor part, the energy part. We should invest in cooling your city at a certain moment, and we should invest in other kind of energies so that you become less independent. These kind of water lilies could become, say, a kind of fantasy that adds to your repertoire and that makes your density more beautiful. It could look like this, floating in your bay and turning and beating avatar in its best senses to get your density up to the top level again. And that, what I would call then at that moment, Super Hong Kong. Having then said that comparative analysis could lead to an agenda of an advanced density, I would like to apply that also on the buildings themselves. EuroHI is an in-between step, before I go back to Asia, on open up our, say, our skyscrapers. This is what we have to make as architects in your densities. And they all start to look the same. If one door go up and go back again, and there are vulnerable objects in this kind of new dense environment. So how to study, say, porosity? We try to do that a little bit in Madrid, in the grand times of Europe, where we could imagine that even other kind of programs would float over Madrid and would open up our skyscrapers and turn it into a kind of more vertical village that way. That if we theorize on that and we start to study porosity in its like more technical senses, and we do it like this, this is the minimum act of porosity that I could do at that moment, then we start to fantasize and speculate how we could do that with different techniques. How another technique, the opening up the belly act, could lead to such a tower, or another theatrical aspect could lead to this one, or a splitting act could lead to this zone, or maybe this could lead to a new tower, etc. Take one parameter, bring it to the max, and find what porosity could mean, what kind of social element I could add to this. So here, the balcony series, the cornflake series, the deviation series, the landscape series, the parasites. They form one, say, observation, how future towers could enhance more and other factors, more social factors that would neutralize the possible, say, crimes that otherwise would surround in this anonymity. So this could then that city be look like, how this army of possible, say, towers could enrich our objects and turn that city in that operation that I was just painting. The bubbles, the bent tower, the terraces, the belly, the beams, the terraces, all together. I end with a conclusion, where actually XS shakes hands with XL. It is an observation that we recently did for this part of the planet, where we find this a battle between two kind of inhabitants, those that want to live in a village and those that want that are forced to live in larger entities. If you look to Shanghai 10 years ago, what happened in these last 10 years, when you look in Seoul, you see similar processes that these old villages have disappeared and vanished and turned into giant, say, blocks. Maps show clearly how the Hutongs from blue went into this block attack, and that you can do that for any of your cities in this region. It leads to this kind of city spaces, where you have facades that beat inequality in that way, where the houses are completely the same and are described in an architectural manner like this. I can't do anything as an architect about it. You rule with your rules everything in that aspect. And you continue with that. This is the recent production. This is what you have on your model board at the moment. And this is what I can predict for the coming time. How are you going to work with this horror, I must say? And give that to a kind of new generation when they come and look to your brochures and want to choose between all the differences, what differences? They become a certain despair is going to happen. So on this spot in Taipei, we are going to try to work on a composition, say a village, where if you make an X-ray, already starts to show that there are individualisms over there and much more choice than you can do in your apartment buildings. And at the same moment, there's a migration process in Taipei that the middle class want to go out in order they can't find a good place. You need these people. You have to keep them in your cities in order to make all your amenities to flourish them. So we try to give this new block a sequence of desires, a cube house, a normal house, a house with a tower, a twin set, a factory, a Catholic one, a barn, a courtyard classical, a runaround, and say a cloud, and then give them some kind of materials. Get them some gardens, make more fences, and give that for anything thinkable. You can choose between the two. So we did some in that way from the beginning to make the favorites. And this is how that neighborhood could start, this block could start to look, and how it grew now into this model, as you can see these days on the spot, and how I still love this composition between this new block and the old ones, and how it can look, go into this trajectory. I'm not going to design it. It's clear that we need you to make that. I want to incorporate everybody in that operation. So we make, like IKEA, a kitchen maker, we make a house maker. You make your house. And then in a village maker, you can position it. You define your viewing line, your sun line. And at that moment, it calculates what is the best, say, position within your price range. And at that moment, with this, say, software, we start to find out the new infrastructure in that place and and how it starts to look like in the end. And we can compare that. What kind of villages can come out of that, out of this process? And here you see it, how it hopefully starts now soon in Taipei, under construction. How I can lead to this kind of environments, which I don't know, and where, say, the 2D zoning that has dominated our former densities turns now gradually into a 3D zoning, urbanism becomes vertical. And with that, I hope to give you a series of thoughts on how I could think that advanced density could look like. Thank you very much.